Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will talk about the main difference between Skerrin cage and slip ring induction motor. So let's start the video. Skerrin cage and slip ring motor are the two types of induction motor. Slip ring motor is also known as wound rotor induction motor. One similarity between both the two types of machines is that they operate on the principle of Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Now let's discuss the basic difference between Skerrin cage and wound rotor induction motor in detail. First of all, we will talk about the slip ring induction motor. The construction of slip ring motor is complicated due to the presence of slip rings and brushes. Moreover, regular maintenance is also required in slip ring induction motor due to the presence of slip rings and brushes. The rotor of a slip ring induction motor is wound for the same number of pawns as that of the stator. So the number of pawns in stator and rotor of a slip ring induction motor is same. Moving on to the next point, the three phase rotor windings are present on the outer surface. Here you can see these are the rotor windings, and the end of these rotor windings are permanently connected to the slip rings. As you can see in the diagram, these are the rotor windings and they are permanently connected to the slip rings. Actually, the main purpose of slip rings and brushes in slip ring induction motor is to add external resistance in the rotor circuit of a wound rotor induction motor. Here you can see in the diagram, this is the external resistance in the rotor circuit of wound rotor induction motor, and you can see that it is connected with the slip rings and stationary brushes. Slip ring motor generally provides a high starting torque. With the help of external resistance, we can also increase the starting torque of a slip ring motor. So with the help of external resistance, we can increase the starting torque of a slip ring induction motor. Moving forward, the starting current of a slip ring motor is low. However, current induced in the rotor windings can be controlled by using a external resistance. So one more advantage of external resistance is that the current induced in the rotor windings of slip ring induction motor can be controlled. The speed of a slip ring induction motor can also be controlled by using a rotor resistance method. Hence, it is a variable speed motor. So this is one more advantage of external resistance, that we can vary the speed of a slip ring induction motor. So these are some of the advantages of external resistance in slip ring induction motor. We can increase the starting torque, the current induced in the rotor windings. The current induced in the rotor windings of slip ring induction motor can also be controlled, whereas the speed of a slip ring induction motor can be varied with the help of an external resistance. Now look at some of the disadvantages of a slip ring induction motor. The rotor copper losses are high in slip ring induction motor and they have a NES efficiency. So the copper losses are high in slip ring induction motor, due to which they have a NES efficiency. These type of motors are expensive due to the high cost, complicated construction and need of a regular maintenance. Only 5 to 10% of the industry uses a slip ring induction motor. So as we have stated earlier, that due to the slip rings and the brushes, slip ring induction motor have a complicated construction and they also need a regular maintenance. So due to that reason, only 5 to 10% of the industry uses a snip ring induction motor. Now let's review the square and cage induction motor so we can easily differentiate between square and cage and snip ring induction motor. The construction of a square and cage motor is simple and robust. Snip rings and the brushes are not present in square and cage motor, due to which less maintenance is required in these type of motors. So due to the absence of a snip rings and the brushes, the construction of a square and cage motor is simple and they also needs a less maintenance. Moving forward, square and cage motor consists of a cylindrical rotor having a skewed snouts in which aluminium bars are placed. Here you can see these are the skewed rotor snouts in the square and cage rotor in which the aluminium bars are present. There are no rotor windings are present in the square and cage motor. The rotor of a square and cage induction motor itself automatically adjusts to the number of opponents as that of the stator. So the rotor of a square and cage rotor automatically adjusts to the number of opponents. Moving forward, square and cage motor has a high starting current. Moreover, current induced in the rotor conductors depend on the motor snip and we cannot control it. So in the case of a square and cage induction motor, we cannot control the induced current and they have a high starting current. Starting torque is very low in square and cage motor. Moreover, external resistance cannot be added since the rotor bars of a square and cage induction motors are short circuited by end ring. Here you can see this is the aluminium or a copper end rings. So we cannot add the external resistance in the case of a square and cage induction motor. And due to that reason, the starting torque of a square and cage motor cannot be increased. So in the case of a square and cage induction motor, starting torque is very low and we cannot increase the square and cage induction motor starting torque due to the absence of external resistance. Now let's discuss some of the advantages of a square and cage induction motor. The rotor copper losses are less in square and cage induction motor and they have a high efficiency. Due to simple construction and no cost, 90 to 95% industries uses a square and cage induction motor. So as we have stated earlier that due to the absence of snip rings and the brushes, they have a simple construction and they also need a less regular maintenance due to which they have a no cost. So due to that reason, 90 to 95% industries uses a square and cage induction motor. It is a constant speed motor since speed control is not possible in square and cage induction motor. So due to the absence of external resistance, the speed of the square and cage induction motor cannot be changed. So it is a constant speed motor. Square and cage induction motor is generally suitable in applications where constant speed is required. These motors are found where no starting torque is needed. So from the above discussion, we can say that square and cage induction motor are generally found in those applications where constant speed is required. Moreover, these types of motors also have a no starting torque. So they are found also in those applications where no starting torque is preferable. So this is the overview of a square and cage induction motor. This is the comparison chart of a square and cage induction motor and snip ring induction motor. These are all the points which we have discussed earlier in the video. So you can easily understand that. Moreover, if you want to read the article of a square and cage induction motor and snip ring induction motor in detail, I will provide you the link in the description. That's all. Hope this video will help you. Thanks a lot. If you like this video, please subscribe. Thanks.